Welcome.
Today I will talk about the Princess Diamond cruise quarantine here in Yokohama in Japan.
I want to talk about the quarantine and the timeline and the controversy. I think it's fascinating following the unpleasant ending of the Diamond Princess cruise throughout Asia, which quarantined 3,711 people on board, 2,666 passengers, and 1,045 crew members from the 5th of February until 19th of February due to the coronavirus outbreak, now known as COVID-19. During this time, I ingest all related news. From the most weird one, when armed robber stole toilet paper in Hong Kong, to a chat history calling for customers of a Chinese call girl in Singapore who contracted the virus. I received friends' messages and we talked about it, and also someone sent me pictures of armed medical staff in China of unknown origin, so I don't want to show them here. I started following few passengers on board the Diamond Princess cruise ship, and I felt most connected to Matthew Smith. And if you follow me on Twitter, you can see who I'm following and you can see their timeline. I will not include photos from them because that's their story, but still I would like to include them in this video, somehow talk about on the sideline about their experience. Matt, who was with his wife on board, seems to be grounded and calm. On the other hand, a young mother with parents and a hubby on board, somehow I could see myself in her because I lived through SARS in Singapore in 2003. She seems rational and grounded, but with temporary panic attacks, which is most probably due to the interior cabin without windows, from what I understand. Matt and his wife had a beautiful balcony. On a side note, since the 18th of February, I post NHK 7 p.m. or 9 p.m. English news about the coronavirus on Twitter with a private link to my YouTube channel. So you cannot find the link unless you follow me on Twitter. Coming back to the story, every Twitter update, I consumed it. I looked at it immediately. Whatever, I was eating lunch or drove on the street, I stopped at the side and looked at it. The food review for Matt were entertaining. He definitely likes roasts, sausages, meat and coffee. A lot of followers try to warn him about the danger of the ship environment or other things. He always replied with confidence and manners. Even doctors seems to chime in, giving advice like, I don't normally tweet, but as a physician, I would have gladly accepted the evacuation. Cruise ships are floating petri dishes. I sincerely hope you made the correct decision and stay well. From da da da. Then on 15th of February, Wall Street Journal article says that the US will evacuate the Americans on the ship. This was for me the most bewildering story of all, and I started to research the timeline of the outbreak on the ship to know if the Japanese are really to be blamed here. Matt stayed on board and got lots of critique from all over the world. Currently, he has to wait another 2 weeks before he's allowed to come back to the US. Then on February 18, Professor Iwata posted a video about the ship quarantine, which puzzled me, because until then I thought they have done a good job.
What do you want to do? Do you want to infect everybody in the ship? There will be thousands of people who could potentially get COVID-19. I don't criticize DMAT people. They were not infection control specialists. A society of infection prevention entered a lot of specialists came in, but they spent only a few days and left. And they said they were fearful of getting infection themselves. I share the same fear because I'm in a single room now, and I'm separated from my family. I'm very scared of getting infection myself, and I'm very scared of infecting my family too. I'll be out of my medical service at Kobe University Hospital for maybe next 2 weeks to avoid further infections to occur. That is very likely to occur if you keep zero infection control inside the ship, Diamond Princess, like this. You might know that there's no CDC in Japan, but I thought there must be some specialist called on and was in charge of infection control in the ship. I was not expecting nobody was professional infection control specialist, and the only the bureaucrats were doing the jobs, completely layman's work, and the violating all the infection control principles, and the risking people inside further infections. So I'm not very surprised to see many new positive PCRs to be broadcasted every day. Hundreds of people got infected, and lots of people from outside Japan decided to take their people away from the ship and bring them to their home countries by airplane, and offer them another 14 days of quarantine. I hope this will be the opportunity to
For me, I wanted to look at the timeline. Are you interested? I found all information on the public domain, and basically it's my own opinion in this video.
On 10th of January, patient number 0 visited Shenzhen briefly. On January 17, he takes a flight to Tokyo, Japan. He stays 3 days in Japan. On the 19th, he is developing a cough and joins the Princess Diamond cruise on the 20th of January with his daughters. The cruise stops in Kagoshima. As you can see on this map, there are no cases in Kagoshima. On 25th of January, the man leaves the ship in Hong Kong. The cruise is going to Chiang Mai, Vietnam, and then to Ha Long Bay in Vietnam. On the 31st, the cruise arrives in Keelung, Taiwan. And on 1st of February, the man in Hong Kong gets his diagnosis, coronavirus. And the Japanese authorities are alarmed. When the Princess Diamond arrives at Yokohama port on 3rd of February, the Japanese government requested that the Diamond Princess stay at port, with no passengers or crew disembarking. During 3rd and 4th of February, health status of all passengers and crew members were checked by questionnaire by quarantine officers, and respiratory specimens were taken from symptomatic passengers, crew, and their close contacts to test for novel coronavirus. On 5th February, a lab confirmed case of COVID-19. This led to a quarantine for the Diamond Princess for 14 days, beginning at 7 a.m. on 5th of February. At the beginning of the quarantine period, crew members were provided with personal protective equipment, PPE, and instructed on appropriate IPC practice.
We have not eaten since 7 p.m. last night, and it is 11:50 in the morning. I'm a diabetic, and I'm insulin dependent, as I've put on to other posts. So I have just been out and spoken to somebody, I don't want to mention their names and their rank and so on, and asked about the lack of food and could I have some, and the response really has surprised me. All services have been stopped aboard the ship because, and this is a face-to-face conversation, okay, all the services on board the ship, including food, have been stopped because the source of the virus has not been determined, and they now think it could be the food that is spreading it. Now, what the blooming heck, man? So I hope this message gets back to Princess Cruises and they can start taking some of the passengers' medical conditions a little bit more seriously than they are at the moment.
On that day were 10 cases of new coronaviruses, and they were distributed to 4 hospitals in Kanagawa Ken. And again, 10 cases. 41 cases the next day. On the 7th, the quarantine officers gave all passengers on board a thermometer to measure their temperature twice a day. So it seems like there were not enough testing kits because it was a new virus, and testing 3,500 or 700 people on board was a huge undertaking. So in the beginning, they told you the first 10 people went in 4 different hospitals. So these are 2.5 people for one hospital. If you look at the whole number, 634 cases on February 20, these are 254 hospitals. Just imagine that. Coming back to the story, on 10th of February, Japan's chief cabinet secretary Yoshida Suga says it is difficult to test everyone on board the cruise ship. He also said the top priority is to ensure the good health of the people on board and ease their concern by taking into account the capacity to process virus test samples. On 11th of February, the captain announced that Japan health officials have provided 45 doctors, 55 nurses and 45 pharmacists on board. On 12th of February, they announced that a quarantine officer has been infected with COVID-19. On 14th of February, an article on NHK tells about the situation on board from the point of view of Dr. Yuichi Fukushima. Dr. Fukushima and his colleagues exchanged all the masks and protective clothing they wore each time they examined one person to prevent the spread of the infection. On the same day, Japan provides free iPhones to all passengers on board. And then we have the dancing crew. Then the shock article from the Wall Street Journal that the United States will evacuate the Americans on board the Princess Diamond cruise. And they have only on that day, this was the 15th of February, 4 days to go. Then on 16th of February, the Americans arrive on board and start to prepare for the evacuation for that evening. I don't understand. It's only 3 days to go. Why? Some Americans decide to stay on board. So after the Americans evacuated the Americans from the Diamond Princess, it turned out a few days later, they said, they evacuated negative and positive cases together. So they were together on one bus. Then on the plane, they separated them. And one couple said they were negative, but in fact, they have been tested, but they have not received their tests back. So, and the husband developed a fever on the flight back to the US. So yeah, totally chaotic. I don't understand why they started evacuating 3 days before the actual quarantine ended. Okay, very difficult to talk under a mask.
So Americans who stayed on board, they had to stay another 14 days in Japan until the 4th of March. On the 18th or 19th, Dr. Iwata uploaded his video and communicated his opinion. It was not clear to me why he was there on the first place, and I actually didn't believe him. But after I researched his name, I found out he was indeed an expert. Yeah, but when he deleted his video then a few days later, I just couldn't take him seriously, because as a professor, once you say something, people will definitely come back to this and they want to have answers. And deleting his video, I don't know, I think it was not right. And there was later a press conference and he tried to explain, and basically at the end he said something like he still has the same opinion, so I'm not so sure. I personally came back to my original opinion that the Japanese did their best, and it's a new virus, and of course they made also mistakes, but I think it was the biggest mistake to evacuate the Americans before the quarantine, and nobody in the world should be able to do this. Once the government decide on a quarantine, nobody should take anybody out. That's my personal opinion. On the 20th of February, Matt and his wife left the Prince of Diamond. And as of 6th of March, they are still in Japan. It was later concluded that COVID-19 spread on Diamond Princess before quarantine.
That's it for today. And I see you next week, Thursday.